Hello, in this video we will learn about switch case. Now in switch case, the switch statement allows us to execute one code block among many alternatives. It is similar to the if-else ladder, but it is easier to read. Now the syntax is switch followed by expression, and within the switch block there are multiple cases where we use the case keyword followed by a constant, which is the case label, followed by the statements that will be executed, and each case label has a break statement. Now how the switch case works. The expression is evaluated once and compared with the values of each case label. Once there is a match, the corresponding statements after the matching case label are executed, and the statements are executed until the break is encountered. If no match is found, the default statement is executed. But remember that the default statement is not compulsory, it is optional. And if we do not use the break, all the statements after the matching label will be executed and it will be a waste of time. Now let's look at a code which has switch case in it to understand how it works. So first we're declaring a character variable called operator, and then two double type variables, that is n1 and n2. Then we are giving the user the option to enter any operator, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication or division, to perform on the two operands. Now the operator entered will be passed to the switch case, and it will match it with the cases plus, minus, multiplication or division. If the operator entered is plus, it will execute this first case. If it is entered minus, it will execute the second case, and so on. But if we enter an operator that is none of the above four options, then the default case will run. So now let's run the program and enter, for example, plus. And we are giving two options, 8 and 9. As you can see that the two operands are added. Now let's run this again. And now let's go for multiplication. And we are giving the numbers 6 and 5. As you can see, it is working properly. Now let's run it again and give an option for an operator that is not one of these four options. So suppose we are entering hash. And it will still give an option for operand, as you can see that the operator is not correct. And that's all for now. Thank you for your patient listening. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel for further videos on this course. Thank you.